Brass Section, obviously, from the Fullerton Community Band. We're delighted to have you with us this evening. I know it's difficult on a weeknight to come on out. That's why we try to get it starting at 7 o'clock, so it's not a late night. But thank you very much for coming out here this evening and listening to us perform. We rehearse on Tuesday nights, so our calendar and our schedule is all set up for Tuesday, so slotting it in on a Tuesday night works out well for us. As they're coming in, this is the rest of the band, the woodwind section, from the Fullerton Community Band. It's been in existence like it is now for about 43 years. And actually, in the history, there was a community band back in the late 19th century even. But this is our community band, and once again, we're delighted that you're here with us this evening. We'll continue with the program, playing Landscapes by Rossano. Galante, thank you very much. From the outside world, if you would please turn your phones off, and like I say in the movies, no texting please, it disturbs other people around you. So if you want to double check that right now, make sure that your phones are turned off. It's been an ambitious program that we put together this evening, maybe one of the more challenging programs in a total that we've done for a while. I really like this third symphony of James Barnes, and I think it makes a little more sense if I can read just a little bit about, we're doing two of the movements, just the third movement and the fourth movement. And this is what the composer had to write. The Third Symphony was commissioned by the United States Air Force Band in Washington, D.C. The conductor of the band at that time, Colonel Alan Bonner, told me that he wanted a major work for wind band. He said that he didn't care about the style, the length, the difficulty, or anything else. I was given complete freedom to write whatever I wanted to. I began to work on it in earnest at a very difficult time in my life, right after our baby daughter, Natalie, died. This symphony is the most emotional, draining work that I have ever composed. If it were to be given a nickname, I believe that tragic would be the appropriate. The third movement is a fantasia about what my world would have been like if Natalie had lived. It is a farewell to her. The finale, the fourth movement, represents a rebirth of spirit and a reconciliation for all of us. The second theme of the last movement is based on an old Lutheran children's hymn called I Am Jesus' Little Lamb. This hymn was sung at Natalie's funeral. The last stanza of the song reads, "Who's so happy as I am, even now the shepherd's lamb? And when my short life is ended, by his angels host attend, he shall fold me to his breast, where there within his arms to rest." 3 days after I completed the symphony, on June 25th, 1994, our son Billy was born. The third moment is for Natalie, then the finale is really for Billy and our joy in being blessed with him after the tragic death of his sister. This is the Third Symphony of James Barnes, movement 3 and 4. It's a real pleasure for me, and it will be for you as well, to welcome our special guest. I always find it kind of good during a band concert to maybe have a different sound. We've had strings before and so forth, vocals, and it just kind of gives you a little ear floss. Change your ears out a little bit. Kihae Kim, you can see her bio. She's a fantastic cellist. She's a colleague of mine that teaches at Oxford University, Oxford Academy, and many of the colleges around. She brought about 20 of her students here this evening as well. We're just very delighted, and it's a pleasure to have. Would you please welcome me, Kihae Kim. She's accompanied with my dear friend David Dunford on the piano. You can give it up for him too. Thank you. There we go. November 7th, didn't realize when I set up this concert, you know, we had to get the calendar with the school, with the district, with other activities and ours as well. Turned out that it's David Dunford's birthday today.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear David. Happy birthday to you.
I'm so used to singing that for everyone else. I was singing that along and I realized everyone was supposed to be singing. Well, sort of in keeping to the theme, so this, I guess, is supposed to be a big birthday, right? It's like 10 and 10 and 10 and 10 and 10 or something like that. So, you know, you often take times and you ponder when you get to moments like this. You know, what were some of the influences in music in my life? And there are a lot of pianists, young pianists that I saw, and they would take these very simple tunes that they would play in church and they would wind them up into these very fancy kinds of things, and similar to what you heard some of the band, and you hear a little bit later in the band, or tunes, and they're arranged in certain ways, and so that was one of the big drivers for me. A guy named Dino Karkonakis, and other like that, and so there's two very simple tunes that I'm doing an arrangement for, I sung early on. I knew these tunes, and so I just kind of played around with them and came up with an arrangement. So the tunes are The Old Rugged Cross and Oh, How He Loves You and Me.
Thank you.
little word about Shine as the Light by Peter Graham. Shine as the Light is dedicated to the memory of Al Holzberger, a captain in the Salvation Army and friend and colleague of the composer. The music depicts the journey from darkness to light, expanding on the theme of a song by composer Joy Webb, The Candle of the Lord. Webb's song provides both the textual and the thematic basis, and particularly a falling third figure. The extended climax of Shine as a Light commences when the section of music during which the woodwinds and the bells literally paint a picture of a line which says a myriad of tiny flames expanding into the whole. Underpinning its free selection is the phrase "light me," repeated three times in the low brass with ever-increasing intensity. The unfolding of the symphonic development leads to a final Salvation Army song, "The Light Has Come," in a literal blaze of sound and symbolic spiritual enlightenment. Shine as a Light by Peter Graham. Thank you. Thank you very much, and have a good night. Drive safely home.